Good afternoon, Thobela. It's just a brief announcement. I am informed that we have now gone live, or the ceremony has now gone live on Facebook and on YouTube. And the brief announcement is just for all of us that are here, we can see that we're still waiting for the family to join us. But for those that are with us online, it's just to inform them that we're waiting for the family. And we should be starting hopefully in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's an awesome God. He's a wonderful God. Oh.
Shadow.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's an awesome God. He's a wonderful God. Oh.
Mohalite,
Ayo Mata,
Ayo Mata.
We sing together.
And the children are now coming to join us. If we can just please rise up on our feet to give them the honor.
Special lady.
Thank you. We are now going to start with the business of our ceremony. And at this stage, we will be requesting that Baruti batle ba re bulele ka a short word and some prayer.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters in Christ. Aho dumise Jose Christe, Maria Yomgeto, Josepha Yomgeto, Josepha Yomgeto. Before I can say a short prayer, I've got my colleagues here, Mr. Mkavela. He's also a, you can stand up. Mr. Mkavela is also a, with us, and Ntate Metlape Jegi. We are from a cathedral, Roman Catholic Cathedral in town. We are just going to share with you an opening word. We, the members of our parish, want to share in your bereavement and want to console you with our prayers. In moments of like this, our only hope and strength is in God's word. That is the only prayer that we're going to say, and then we'll do another one when we close. So, Mr. Program Director, you can start with your... Thank you.
Thank you, Ralebowa. Ralebowa Ntate Mruti. Hopefully, all or most of us would have heard the programs being shared with them, today's programs. We are going to try and move as speedily as possible through the program. You'll appreciate, given the time that we are starting, and even in this season, in no long at all, it will be dark, so it would be better indeed if we were to move as speedily as possible. And so, by way of opening remarks, I should just briefly indicate that it does not need an announcement that we are here in all of our numbers to show support to the family. Our brother, our friend, son, father, uncle, nephew, and husband to Mphosi that Theo indeed was to all of us. It's something in the nature of a tall order. It's a tough ask, and it's something surely that none of us would have raised their hand up for. And but then we are all compelled. We are compelled by our honor to the man. We are compelled by our duty to support the family, to be here and to indeed take part in these ceremonies in his memory. Our first speaker is going to be Ntate Joe Maloka. He is the representative of the Robinson family. For those that are not aware, the Robinsons are Theo's in-laws. And Dr. Maloka, please, if you can come to the fourth.
Ladies and gentlemen, Help me to put your hands together as we welcome William Sejoka.
Tobela Varish. Ngasbagar Zuili, you are Kanega, Tsivagam Ganarana. Re Aime Ralokun. Sesolu, Sesilongwana, Jubaudu, Chia, Dilotarena, Lidimonga Rotarena. Radilivisha wena mongwarena ena o a thotseng le fase a thola le yona phofolo e kgolo re reng ke motho kana ke yena o dithulaganyo tse ka mokanang ga tsona di dirile go ke yena ba gaeso le ge re lela ka yena mokgwano re le batho e be ke re a re khomotseng le linyane nyana fela la go du leboga ono re ena mothodi wa rena o re mushitelang ka matsatsi yotlhe ntlile anka a re fa ngwana o a tshwanang le ena o re tlile ka ena mo lekgono e leng Theo ngwana yo go di generations tse di satlang le bana ba ba leng gona gone yano ba swanetseng go tšea malebiša ka metlhala e a e gatilego o thank you ona ke fela ke tshoga kere kane lentswe la ka ke ne lentswenyana la godimonyana kere se ka taka le thiba ditsebe modimo e le a re atla garga me sokolela be le gona ke re be re tšogana kwa tšokolongela ya ngwagengela ya apartheid re tseneng mo democracy arfa o mongwe mo baneng ba rena o go nna beng e le mogonyana mara nna be ke sa ke mmitsa mogonyana e be setse re mo tšea ka ka o mongwe wa leloko la gešo ke motša kaka o mongwe wa batlogolo baka ke sa bone bokgonyana mo go yena ke di o bona ngwana wa leloko lešo ba bantši ba lena le bone mediro wa gage e be a sa robale e be a šoma ka thata le gona mo go iša mafelong a gage le bone ka mokana a lena ke motho a kreyang leeto la gage la mafelelo le felelang a e tswa mošomong a le busy le go bona gore o direla ba lapa la gage ba gešo ba ga Mphosi re tle a re kgomotšegeng go setogolo sa ka ntšhadi le bana ba gage re re tshepang go wa godimodimo o tla letlhatlha go ya go sa feleng ba gešo re ke se ka taka bolela go subela kudu moswaramarapo wa batafa bana le nna kgoši e reng e re ke ya leboga.
I surrender my all to you, oh God, oh God, I give my all as a living soul.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Robinson. I must just say to the other speakers, myself included, that I keep getting reminders from the technical side there that we need to put the mic very close to our face, or very close to our mouths, so that we can be better audible. And the assurance also is that we should not worry because we are sanitizing these masks, these microphones, with every speaker that comes up here. Our next speaker is, or a series of our next speakers, I don't know how they have arranged that, but the item says that it's going to be the children's turn now, led by Chego. Just one second, Chego. My memory seems to have failed me. Chego, sorry, not yet. I am reminded by Rangwane Slai here that it should be Noko that's coming up. Noko Rapudi, on behalf of friends, to the family.
This tribute feels a little bit strange. The passing of Theo feels unreal. When someone so full of life, so bold, so courageous, you almost think they are invincible and that they would never, that they would overcome anything. But obviously, God had other plans. Theo taught me a lot of things. He taught me to be compassionate. He taught me generosity, he taught me courage, and he taught me hard work. Theo taught me style. That man could dress, as you can see for yourself on the pictures. He would always tell me it is important for a good image and always dress how you want to be addressed. I remember there used to be these jeans when we used to grow, Baraki Kalkani, and he would force me and Lazarus to wear those jeans. He taught me a lot of things, this man, and he told me that you should always strive for the best and not be apologetic about it. He would always remind me of when we were young and he paid me 10 rand to go to Cicerelli's house or Ahonomon. The last time I saw Theo was on Thursday when he called me up or Ria Saluni to get the haircuts. And in hindsight, I think my brother was bidding me farewell. So, Brathio, a golden heart has stopped breathing, hard-working hands have rested. And even though life has to end, love doesn't. You're not only leaving a legacy, but a footprint in our hearts. And we will always, always remember you. Good night, Brathio, till we meet again.
My heart, my mind, my soul, I give you.
Thank you, Chiro. That item that I seemed to rush earlier on, this is the moment.
Thank you to everyone that has made it here, and I greet everyone in the name of Jesus Christ. I have no words to express how I feel. I feel so incomplete, and as a family, we feel incomplete. For a man with so many tricks, this was one of his worst tricks ever. I didn't see myself standing here and actually having to speak about him not being here. And not being with us. I refuse to believe that he's gone, not just me, but us as a family. It's going to be hard for us to move on from this. It's going to be hard for everyone to carry on, not just me, but as a family, and as friends, and as colleagues. I refuse to believe that everything happened for a reason, because for what good reason could God have taken him away from us? We've lost you, but it's difficult for us to find peace. I don't believe that we'll ever find peace, but as time goes on, we will find peace. It won't be easy. It won't be easy. Not now, not ever. But I'd like to always say, and I'd like to use your words, that it's us. Not just us, it's us against the world. Just when we've all thought that you're back home, and the change we've all been praying for, and the change we've hoped for, and this happened. 24 years of living, I've never had a friend. I've had friends, I've had brothers, but I've never had a best friend. But today, I'm incomplete because I've lost my best friend. Not just my best friend, but a father. I hope you rest in peace. I hope where you are, you're looking over us and laughing like you'd always do. I hope you're happy where you are, and I hope God can keep you as close as possible just for you to take care of us. In heaven, an angel like you is very special. Death be not proud.
Good afternoon, everyone. I wanted to just thank you on behalf of myself and my family for being able to make it. So I racked my brain today trying to figure out what I could possibly say to speak about a man with such due diligence. But I realized that we all have different experiences of him. And I want everybody to remember him intimately with the experience that they've known him by. So, ladies and gentlemen, Mama, Slai, Marping, and Jawa, instead of giving a speech, which I felt would not adequately begin to describe the man my father was, I've written a letter to him, which is my final conversation. Hello, Daddy. It's me. It's Matepo. I don't know whether to cry, to laugh, or simply scream and shout at you for making such a dramatic exit. But knowing the kind of man you are, I don't think you would have wanted to go out any other way. I'm sorry for crying when I speak of you lately, because I know just how much you hated seeing me cry. But a few days ago, when I was anxiously prepping to write my June mid-year exams, I had no idea that I'd be preparing a farewell speech to my mom's soulmate, my little sister's superhero, and my big brother's best friend. But most importantly, my heart in human form. Our relationship was far from perfect. We fought, we cried, we screamed at each other, we laughed. We went weeks mad at each other, and then we went weeks inseparable. But one thing that I thank you for from the bottom of my heart is finding time to always remind me just how much you love me. I miss you, Daddy. Not your smile, not your voice, and most definitely not that chunky caller laugh. I miss the way that you would hold on an extra 2 seconds after every single time that you gave me a hug. I miss the way that you'd sneak in junk food after a garage run on a bad day. I miss seeing you squirm and do a little prayer every time I mentioned a boy's name. Believe it or not, I actually miss you quoting Zahara lyrics at 2 a.m. in the morning when I have school the next day. But amongst all things, I miss your sense of humor, and I miss the imperfectly perfect man you were. We had so many dreams for my future. 5 out of 7 distinctions in matric, business school, law school, you name it. You always believed that there was no dream too big or too unattainable. You allowed me to be me, to speak my mind, and being your daughter is undeniably the most incredible blessing that God could have ever given me. Not because you were perfect or because you lacked faults, but because you raised me to be the most unapologetic version of myself. I'm not sure about the 5 out of 7 distinctions thing, because as you'd say, matric is nie matras nie. But one of our dreams has suddenly came true, Daddy. UCT acceptance letter. And I wish nothing more than to share this moment with you. With that being said, Daddy, Papa, Mtizolo, Mshabi, I miss you like crazy, and I have no idea what the road ahead has in store for us without you. But I don't want you to worry, because I've got this. I've got you, and I've got us. And I promise we'll find a way to keep on moving. Now it's your turn to start a new chapter, one more rewarding than we'll ever be able to comprehend. So until next time, Papa, rest. I love you more than life itself, and I promise to live a life from this day forward that you'll be proud of. I'm not sure if heaven has gained just an angel, but I'm certain that it's gained a man with a smile that warms, a heart that loves, and a soul that radiates happiness, peace, and love. Until we meet again, Rabala Kakuj.
Honyani, it's your turn, brother. Honyani will now come and say a few words on behalf of the staff.
Rata o dumedisa batho ka moka ba ba le mo tenteng e botse ya modimo kere God bless you all. Ke tlile fa ke le Gonyane MG ke le o mongwe wa di manager cha Mr. Theo Mphosi ile yena our boss. Bana besho ke rata o bolela gore se se tsweletseng fa se re sekweleng sitile jwala ka le rumo pelong tsa rena re le ba shumi ba globale bana be sho re re le ritisha me boyeng le re rapedisheng a re tse bo re tlo gona o khopa ka se se re tlhaetse nna kwa moshumong ka hore monno ke senatla re se re bileng sona le ke le tshere ka ba re di gonne re feletse re bile le malapa ka bakala mogopolo wa gagwe wo o ikgetlhileng o nonneng wo o thušitseng batho ka moka re ka se epale ka maina o mongwe le mongwe o a tseba gore na senatla se se ralokile karolo e kaka mo bophelong ba gagwe jwale re re Mr. Theo Mphosi sepela botse mediro ya mebotse o e dirile o re dirile batho o tlhotse company e kgolo ye botse ya global wa tsiya kgetho le kano ya malema wa bona o le botlhokwa gore o re thwale re bereke le wena mo businesseng ya gago jwale senatla se o re tloetse papa a re tsebe goreng re jwale ka motho a sa aparang gore ge re shile ko wena ke eng se re tlo se dirang o motho wa kgopolo ye e nonneng e botlhale ya o ikgetha ka dinako ka moka esh global re wele ka mahlong fela re 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 a dumela gore dilo tse dingwe le tse dingwe se se tlhagalang re dumela gore ke morero o mogolo wa modimo le le re ye re 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 tla šala re tseyang re beya ka gore boss rena re mmitsa ke boso ya rena mogalabo o ge re bolela le yena matlobale le gona ke no gopela le no emela hanyane fela ke gopela ba bere ke batlobala please stand up your feet mara le kholenyana ke no re ba ba di ba bararo come forth ba le ka gona please come forth
I surrender my all to you, oh God, I give my all as a living sacrifice.
But baleng le nafa ke team ya Mr. Theo Mphosi our boss ga se ba felelele ga re le so o mongolongona le karolo ya ha ya dirang go mshumo wa Mr. Theo Mphosi jwale re request-le botlhoko ke sa busheletsa ke re a re tsebe gore re tlo gona o ya pele jwang ntle le Mr. Mphosi Theo mara re you the family ntle le lena a re bone re tla gona family etlang le re hlahleng le re bontsheng direction gore le ge one of your brothers a se sa le gona dilo di tlo tswela pele ke se rapelang ke se gopelang gore mama ye mong a leng gona global a tswele pele ke gopela lena family re na re ka se se ba ka re hakaneile or without him re tla tsheng re tla be re tla di yae re tla gona na jwale ye inyaka lena re na re kemishile tsho shoma le company ya Mphosi le company ya global go le jwang re rata o ba ba shumi ba lena for good le rena modimo a tlo tsa kano o ba karolo go tswana le se se gapa se se tlhaelang le khono a rena di plan e tshedingwe tsa hore re ka ya kae a rena kgopolo tshedingwe tsa hore re ka ya kae ga go sana farka ya ngwa ba borutho o tswana le motlobal jwale bana besho Mr. our boss is gone guys ntwe ebe ke bolela le o mongwe wa bašomišana ka nna Mr. Jamil a re maragonyane is it true our boss is gone ka re Mr. Jamil le nna a ke dumele ga botse
ke tlo re ke dipitsi ra bona ka mebala jale le khone ga ke bona phutho ya modimo hele ka tsela ye ke ya dumela gore my boss is gone ga go se re ka sedi yang bana besho boss wa rena o re tloetse Mr. Mphosi is gone guys go motse yang re rapedishaneng re bengata ye tee le maemo a le bothata ka tsela ye re sa gone o khopa mara modimo o tla re loela a ke tse gore ke ya kwala na phutho yesu phutho ye botse ye ratang ke modimo re latlhegetswe le lena dithapelo tsa rena mo bothateng bo re le mo bona di ka dira se sengwe ko modimong ke re ke ya leboga motshwara marapo sebaka se o mfileng sona le lena bašomišana ba ka di-colleagues tšaaka modimo wa lerata modimo o tla re rarolela bothata bo re leng ka ra bona thank you god bless you all thank you chairman thank you motshwara marapo
Next two speakers are also from Global, and I propose that perhaps it would just be more convenient if you, the both of you, Faith and Chantel, were just to come up here and speak one after another. Faith and Chantel.
Giving me this opportunity to talk about our CEO on this said day. My first encounter with Mr. Mphosi was when I started working at Global in 2011. We only had 5 stations by then, and now we have 138 filling stations. That shows that he was the real captain of this company as it's growing big. By then, we were only 2 employees. Mr. Theo was an honorable man. He was just not our CEO. He was our brother. As you know that Global Oil is a family business. He was our brother, and then he valued his employees. On that note, when it comes to work and fulfilling your responsibilities, he expected nothing but the best. On our last formal meeting, when he just called me just to appreciate my work, I'm so grateful, and I will continue giving it my all to this company. I was privileged to work with Mr. Theo. His untimely death was a shock to me. Rest in peace, sir. You'll forever be in our heart. Thank you.
You are holy. Greetings all. It is very difficult to stand here in front of you this afternoon and speak about our CEO in the past form. Having experienced his jolly mood, smiles and charisma, no one prepared us for this day, nor whispered in our ear that this day will come wherein we will bid farewell to our beloved CEO. Words fails us and emotions overtakes us as we try to express ourselves. Mr. Theo Mphosi was a great leader and a great businessman. He was passionate about and very disciplined when it comes to how things should be done. He had a humor for the employees. He cared about every single one of us, from the cleaner to the managers. He would greet them all as he walked past with a great smile on his face. As his employees, we have lost a great man and a leader of note. At this moment, all we can promise him is that we shall shoulder on from where he left and fight to bring the dreams he had to reality. To everyone, directors, family, chairman, we are here for you. We will be your place of comfort during this time. We pray that you come to terms of this, even though it's not easy. But in time, you shall overcome. Rome 14, verse 8. If we live in the Lord. And if we die in the Lord. So ever we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Thank you. I just want to ask the global choir to please come forward. The three songs that you guys have prepared for today. Everyone can come forward. Worthy is the name of me.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God, look at the motive.
kimela Jesu Jesu mpa matla pokolong Lebushu utonkonehela Jesu Jesu la tsitalelo Jesu la tsitalelo
Even if we can go through all the diverse temptation, we are counting it all joy, for all things work together for our good. We can be pressed down, but we know that we can never be destroyed. We know that in all creation, there is nothing at all that can separate us from the love of God. Rest in power, Mr. Theo Mphosi. Rest in power, Mushabi. And I love it when Davida said, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Even if I can go through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for the Lord is with us." Rest, Boso Yarena. Rest, Mr. Mphosi. Rest, Mushabi. We love you, sir.
Shut the heart,
Thank you so much. There's going to be a slight deviation to the program that you might have in your hands. We are now going to have an offering by Theo's mother-in-law, Ma Robinson. Ma Robinson.
So my Jesu Christe. Good people, I greet you all in the name of Jesus. I decided to come and stand here. You are all aware that I'm not on the program, but I felt it would be an injustice just to leave my son-in-law without even saying goodbye to him. In our culture, some will say it's abnormal. It's not right, but I'm going to make it right for today. Theo married my last born daughter, Nchadi. It was immediately after I'd lost my firstborn. So one day when Theo came to my house holding a bunch of roses, I'm here to see Nchadi with a bunch of roses. I said, who are you? I'm Mphosi. I said, Mphosi, now I've got a small baby here who doesn't need roses. No, mommy, now I'm just a Rayleigh's friend. What? Hey. I was not happy because I was always guarding for my daughter. She should not leave me. She must always be with me. But it happened to I should see Theo Hanji in my house. It means this thing is serious. They continued, and then, but Gabona, a very decent young man. You know, at their age, people really give out flowers. In fact, not now. I mean, 10, 12 years ago. So I started to know Theo Gawanari. He's got good intentions. Well, as an adult, I knew that, in fact, I know that he'll disappear, come back, just like all men, you know. And I gave room. I gave one of my daughter, Aina Liena. And then they were blessed with a baby girl, Matsepo, the one who was just standing here. Theo decided to marry my daughter. He asked for her hand, and then we agreed because I could see her. This man will give my child a home and my grandchildren a home. And indeed, that's what he did. He's still doing it even when he's standing there. The giant that we see there, he made me very proud. I was proud to be the grandmother of these four kids. Eleba Theo, Le Reilly. And to Theo, I was not his mother-in-law. I was more like a mother. I don't remember the day when I came in his house. Kikrailori has got, he has changed, or he doesn't seem to appreciate me. Ekitsenakakwa, a hug, I must just get a hug and a kiss on my cheek. And we lived together. Lena, he used to guide me. So many things, he has done so many things for me, and then even taught the wife, Horna, how should a business be run. But I think at times he was very jealous to be with the wife at the workplace. So he decided to let the wife come back home. Adulikahai. But that was really nothing. Theo, I loved him, and I still love him. It will never change. As a mother, I understand her. I wanted my child, Askabali, Sbanibani no Sbanibani, Sbanibani, Mobopilumbar. And it was like she understood me very well. It was Theo, and even now, when he left, it was Theo of it had to the end. So I'm proud of him. I'm proud of him. I don't know how to express myself, but I must just tell you that he was a wonderful father. Banabahari, they came first. If Okabali Poshonyana, then Ahupula Kabana, then so, Nchadi, Mulikanwa was a pitching wanaka. This does not mean this is the end of the Mphosi family. God has joined you with this family, and you were always there for your husband, for other relatives, Mphosi. Don't change. Worry, because he's gone, now I'm turning into a new leaf. New leaves, they don't thrive in this world. You have got sisters-in-law, Libona Bahona, Cindy, Le Maud, Le Lazaro Suhona, Gehopela or Libona, Batsibur, you are Unganabona. This world is too small, but life, in fact, life is too short. So, helesa tshwarane botse ka mokagalena. Ditlo kra letsena ke batho ba ba mogare mo. Ba le dia gore le sekela kwana forever. Dilo tse ke tsale fasile. They remain here. When we leave empty-handed. You see the giant here. He has left us empty-handed, but he had inspired us deeply. He has done so many things. But because God Lena Urila Libellar, I also want this flower. He decided, no, I can't leave it to the world. I want it for myself. At the age of 40, Limusadiana 40. They had their ups and downs. like every one of us. He had his failures, but who doesn't? Nagiri, those who know Theo in their own way, keep it to yourself. Keep it to yourself and let others live their own lives. I hope you understand me. Let these children grow in peace. I want you to see all of them. They must come and stand here. Sly, come, big boy. Matsepo, you come, all of them. You see this big man. Theo Mphosi is a child and raised him up as his own. He's my late daughter's son. And then when the kids were saying Papa, he was also saying Papa, until the end. According to him, he knew Theo to be his father until today, and it won't change. All what I want to say is that these are Theo's kids. When you see them, because life has got its ups and downs, please, if things are not going right with them, help them just like Theo did. He helped many of you to stand up on your feet. And he did not discriminate anybody. You all know his he was always searching his pocket to help those who needed help. Thank you, Megwensi. This is Sidipa. Sly. Matsepo is the firstborn. Sly, Sidipa. The youngest is Marupin. Marupin is in grade 1. I thank you for honoring Theo today, all of you. By coming here, you had a lot. You were supposed to be doing some other things, some other chores in your houses, but you decided that let's go and honor this giant. I'm proud to be the mother-in-law of Theo. I am. I want him to go in peace. I know that no one will ever get into his shoes. They'll either be too small or too big. Farewell, Mushabi. Farewell, O Sipile Woodsy. Dimoratila, which you come on fastenly. Canaco ye, O Suchu, Senora, or Lua, now you are one of the angels in heaven. Thank you. Farewell, Mphosi. Kelebuha for listening to me. Bye.
To our program, Jwale Tloba Sebaka sa Rangwane Sly. Thank you.
Dumelang. My sister Rayleigh. Bana ba ka Tshego, Matshepo, Sly, Maruping. Robinson family. Mphosi family, Mtlatlana family, Global and Rainland staff, business associates, our dignitaries that we have here today and the community at large. The past few days have proved to me more than ever the impact that my brother had on a lot of people. The comfort and the support that we've received in the past few days has been overwhelming. Just for a memorial service. Theo has always been my best friend, my advisor, my role model, my only brother. Every step that he followed, I wanted to follow in his footsteps. I remember growing up, my mom would always complain and say, "Agyabelewa ma twinsin." Because if she gave us chores, and she's maybe we are at the supermarket or we are at home, and she says, "Theo, you do this, Lazarus do this." Can't you guys separate? I remember the fondest memory that I have of my brother. I was in standard three. Those who know Theo, you know he's always a joking guy. He'll always like to trick you and prove a point. So we had these BB guns. Then he took the BB gun. He's like, "Lazarus, look, I'm killing myself. Pa, ha, ha, ha. Come now, you kill yourself. But you must shoot yourself in your mouth." Little did I know when he slipped the gun to me. See those BB guns, you can put the bullet through the front. He quickly blew a bullet through the front. And I took that gun, pa! I just felt cold in my mouth and this pain. Until today, I've still got the gap to show where that tooth is gone. So for those who see the gap, that's how it came. I was tricked by Theo. And there's been many more other tricks which have been there. Theo was a dreamer and he was a visionary. And no matter how difficult the situation got or how hard things got, he never stopped dreaming. There's been times where we pulled very, 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 very hard. But because of him, I managed to man up and pull through. I remember my 3 years in varsity. It was a very dark time. I just lost my mom. We used to speak every day. And he would tell me, "Don't forget, I've been to varsity. Now I'm working. Now it's your turn for varsity. Just enjoy the life. After 3 years, we are going big time in business. We are going to strike it big in business. Once we start working together, they're not gonna touch us." And he said it so well that you could taste it and you believed it. We would sit together and fantasize at night about how we would like to grow our business, how we would like to get into business and so forth. There's not a person who you can speak to who would not describe Theo as someone with a personality that's larger than life. He had this thing about you that you had to remember him. Whether you met him for a day or for a year or for a month, but you had to remember him. The old man would always tell us when we were sitting together that, "My son, you are very intelligent." The old man was very proud of him. Just last night, I was chatting to Rayleigh, and she was going on about what a fighter Theo is, how he's always been a fighter, how he never, ever gave up. But my best explanation of him, it came one day when I was with the bodyguards. And I hear them talking about this guy saying, Upunyuga uyeza. I'm like, who's Punyuga? They're like, Upunyuga bampet. I'm like, who's Punyuga bampet? They're like, Boss Theo. So what Punyuga bampet means is like a fish. You can catch it. Always said, any situation, I can slide myself out of it. He used to pride himself in that. This past week has been very difficult, especially Monday and Tuesday. I spent the entire day with the boys. I took them to the mall. And I saw that now more than ever is not a time to break down. Because Theo's race is not complete. Where he left off is where I'm going to continue. Banabaga Cheo, Matsepo, Slae, Maruping, you have nothing to worry about. Nothing is going to change. Really, my sister, you've always played more than a sister role in my life. You remember for my matric dance, you were there representing me as my parent. Through a lot of difficult situations, I would come to you, you would advise me. You are a very strong person. So carry on with that toughness that you have. And don't look for any confirmations from anybody. Mustana ebaorata. Do not doubt that. Mustana ebaorata. So don't look for any other confirmation. I am telling you that. Wara ebaorata. There is a lot of unanswered questions. It's very difficult now. We are all still in pain. But we are going to carry on. We've had very good times and very bad times as well, my brother and I. But the one thing that I'm happy for is every time I needed a brother, he was there. There would be times where we wouldn't speak for a month or for 2 months. But then come my son's birthday, he buys the biggest gift. And he dances the most. There's a video that's trending. I've seen it 100 times. It was at my son's birthday. He danced the most. Everybody remembered him at that party. So, Ishe, Chimbela Zwavu Odeateri. Etela Ngamudaro. Thank you.
My all to you, oh God, oh God, I give my all as a living sacrifice to you.
I was just remarking to the lady standing next to me here that I had imagined when the program said Sesi Sara that it was going to be someone much older. But yeah, here is Sesi Sara.
I greet you all in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Like my brother said, I'm actually very old. I'm 10 years older than Theo. Ba Robinson, Ba Mphosi, Ba Mthathana. It is very painful. Theo always referred to me as my lovely sister. I was not just a sister, but I was a lovely sister. Like one of the employees said, he had this thing about him of validating people, making people to feel worthy of themselves. Like other people said, he was such a giver. He was very brilliant. I remember, I don't know where we were traveling, but we were traveling. He was around 21 years. He said, Sarah, I am going to retire at 40. I'm going to work so hard. I'll have so much money. At 40, I can choose to retire. But I was not looking at the type of retirement. For me, it was like he is just now going to, you know, travel more than he would have traveled. But he probably was talking about a different retirement because just in April, he turned 40. He was a visionary, like they said. And from a very young age, he was very courageous. I remember a situation I cannot mention, but at his age, you know, he came and he took me out of that challenging situation that would have needed. At that time, he didn't have bodyguards, and you know, but by himself, he took me out of that situation at such. He was very courageous, though I am older than him. But he was like, you know, is there such a thing as a small big brother? But he was there. He always had my back. Like Lazarus, I know today we're talking about Theo, but you know, because Spedibana let this thing yauri, you know, so I know that I will always, it doesn't matter what situation I would be in, I know they will always be there and come to my rescue, no matter what type of a situation it can be. Really, when is passage by Bilore, Mphosi, Aumwechi, Mwanaka Mphosi. And Theo was able to achieve all this that he was able to achieve because he had a strong, loving wife. He would not have been, he would not have had that compassion. He would not have been the giver that he was if you didn't give him that permission to do that. To all of us, Mphosi, and even other people outside, whenever we were in trouble, we knew that you will always be there. He was able to provide because you were there. I remember one of the tough situations that I had, that I hadn't been working and I had just had this situation. And I was saying to Soli, I think I'm just going to ask Theo if I can sell him the cows so that I can solve this situation that I had. And Soli said, no. Rayleigh said, no. You are not going to sell the cows to Theo because that situation, and one is, we are very grateful, because ubilemulala, guide Theo. You were the neck that helped him to turn in the right direction. He would not have achieved all that he has achieved if you were not there, if you were not supporting him. There is a saying that says, behind a successful man, there is what? Absolutely. So a man will not be successful if he does not have that support and backing of a one. And that's just like my brother has mentioned, we are really very grateful. And to everybody here, we are so grateful that you came to honor my brother. We are really short of words. We are really very grateful. We thank you so much. And Theo Mphosi, yeah, he's been a pillar, like my brother mentioned, to many of you, and we will really, really, really miss him. Like my brother said, it's been a very challenging week. Every time you're like, this seems like, you, it's like you can just wake up from a very, very, grateful to the Lord for that. Thank you.
Thank you indeed. Now the time is for Malume Molebatsi Mohlahlana to come and say a few words. Ba ga Mohlahlana ke ba bo mmago Mohlahlana.
Thank you, Mr. Program Director, for the time that you have given unto me. Karata uli dumedi shaka moka, chava samu dimu se stechen kamo tenten, kere kuchwa ebelele. Allow me, hore ke lebocha hore, Theophilus Ramokokone Mphosi was named after my late father, Theophilus Ramokokono Mphosi. Kibo papa mutu, in other words. So, Mphosi, Theo, the mastermind, in brackets, Mphosi, has rested. So we as the Mphosi, the Robinson, the Mphosi family, we are very sad of what happened, to tell you the honest fact. What caused us together here left us with many questions than answers. We have got a lot of questions than answers. I'm talking as an uncle. You will bear with me because at times you might not, don't always like to hear what you like to hear. At times, don't always like to hear what. Don't always like to hear what you want to hear. At times, allow to hear what you don't want to hear, because that's going to challenge you. It will make you grow. I'm saying this from the bottom of my heart, as an uncle. According to my speculation, my conscience tells me that what brought us here, meaning the death of my motorolo, was orchestrated or well planned. I'm sorry to say that. And if my speculation is correct, I would ask God, in front of you, the mass, that the hand that made us together here, let that hand not find peace from now forward. If Mphosi, Theo, the mastermind Mphosi, his death was orchestrated, if there is a hand that propel my Mutlogolo to leave this earth, I pray that let that hand not get peace. Let me talk about Theo Mosetlana, the mastermind, Mphosi. I remember long ago when he started this filling station empire. He came and talked to me. He said, Malone, I want to start filling station business. I have prepared to have at least 16 filling stations. And you have heard Horena, how many filling stations they have multiplied, how many they are, 100 and something. I said, go well, Motlogolo, wish you all the best. Then the process started. Theo, the mastermind in brackets, successes. He was generous. Allow me to challenge you here. Is there anyone who can say he or she never get help from Theo? Let him stand up. You will never go to Mosetlana asking for help and never get it. Blessed is the hand that give than the one that take. Theo was a community builder. In every community or in every province, there is his businesses or his business. He make it a point that families put a bread on the table by hiring them. All over the country are his filling stations. That shows that he contributed in reducing the rate of unemployment in our country. Hallelujah. I'm glad to inform you that he managed to hire 2,500 employees. That means that he was feeding 2,500 families. We're in a memorial service, I know. Can we clap this thing? Hands, please. It's a round of applause. Thank you. He was not a monster. Theo was welcoming. I still remember his smile, which is like mine. His smile. He was a darling to the people. Everybody, when you can come across anyone, if he tells you that I was with you, you will see that what Baba Batakheji, they were happy, and he will even show his generosity. He looked at the situation. That was how he was. So, Theo Mosetlana, the mastermind Mphosi, may your soul rest in peace, Motholo. You will always be remembered. Ushile a footprint. And to the global family, I would like to tell you that Nature doesn't allow a vacuum. Nature doesn't allow a vacuum. There will be somebody who will replace your boss. Don't worry. As long as God is with you, don't fear, fear not. Don't fear. You will still put bread on the table. Don't fear. And to Lazarus, Selayem Pusi, I say, Mutlohol, carry the baton. Carry the baton that your brother has dropped. Don't drop it. Jolampile, letshwareng bashumi gabotse. You are what you are because of them. Keep on feeding the families. That is what our government is totally changori. Employment must come from private sector. You have made a huge impact by employing 2,500 employees on full-time basis, not on part-time basis. Full-time. It's been the contract charity one now. No. So may the good Lord be with you and expand your territory. Let the sky be the limit. The global family who are with you will be with you in prayers. The sky is the limit. Keep on making this company bigger and bigger than before. Don't say because the boss has left, now everything must vanish. No. This thing is a legacy. It must continue up to the last generation. Mr. Program Director, I thank you.
Going to request Rangwane Slai to come back and give us a few announcements as we go towards the end of our ceremony.
Thank you, Floyd. Just a few brief announcements. The first one, I don't want to call it an apology, but it's on behalf of Mr. John Mphosi, my father, Theo's father, and my sister Cindy, who are not present here today. In our culture, the week of the funeral, the parent has to be present at home to welcome everybody who comes and pays their condolences. So that's the reason why they are not here today. The second one, just for the funeral arrangements, tomorrow morning at 3 o'clock, my brother's body will arrive here in Broadlands. We will have a short prayer and leave at 3:30 to Rainland. From 5 o'clock to 7 o'clock tomorrow, there'll be a prayer service at Rainland. And the funeral service is going to be on Saturday from 7 a.m. in Rainland. Since well, we've come to the end of our program now, there's going to be some refreshments that are served just behind this white tent. And once again, thank you for everybody who took time out to come and be with us today. Thank you.
Thank you. We are now going to take a few words and perhaps some prayer from Baruti in closure of our ceremony. And then afterwards, there will not be any more speakers. Our ceremony would then have come to an end. What we would request is that as the wife and children and close family members, as they leave, we once again play the song that they entered with, and that all of us in attendance, we again return to our feet as an extension of our love and support to the wife and the children indeed. I realized that in the beginning I had not introduced myself. My name is Floyd Logodi. I too am Musahlana's friend and a friend of the family. Moruti, thank you.
Thank you, Program Director. Before I say a concluding prayer, Bahalabala by Shubar Lemuna, when I work it's EVs. You're looking at which are lucky pay here, came out through me, get a high. Tobe, let us pray. Lord, you showed us the depth and the power of your love when your son suffered and died for us on the cross. Today we count again on your tenderness and power. Give to your servant Theo, our brother, the grace to partake in the victory of Christ's death, to share in his resurrection. We ask this in our Christ. Give our brother eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever. Strengthened by these words, let us go in peace. Our prayer has ended. Amen.